Welcome back to the show. Again, we're joined by Jeremy Levitt from serviceseeking.com.au, and we're talking about renovations. So if you've got time over this Christmas holiday, maybe you could think about doing some renovations and see if it can increase your property's value.
We had the idea of coming out with sort of like an interactive yellow pages where you simply describe what you need and only interested businesses contact you, but with a price. And I think that was the golden nugget of the idea. It's just that the tradie would actually contact you, give you the price over the phone or via email, and they could do the job straight away. And that's why we created Service Seeking, a sort of services marketplace where only interested businesses contact you who can do the job.
And look, I mean, there's a massive need out there because we do renovations in our company and we try to check some prices and say, right, let's get 10 quotes, get 10 people to come round. But you can't get 10 people coming round and then you can't get a proper quote. It's a really hard thing, isn't it?
It's amazing. I think a lot of tradies play the bluffing game. You know, can I get out there? Can I do a site visit? I'll give you a price when I see you. They don't give you an indicative range or, you know, how much a similar job in the past might have cost, you know, another customer like you. And I think the great advantage with Service Seeking is that before you even see them for a site visit, they've given you their hourly rate or their price per square meter, and you can pretty much gauge how much the job's going to cost before you even entertain the particular tradie.
Now, on the show, we're always telling the property investors and the viewers out there about kind of education and knowledge and things like that. A lot of them would be in business as well. So we actually met at the Entrepreneurs Organisation, or EO as a lot of people call it. Do you want to tell the viewers maybe why you joined EO and what you get out of it? So what potentially could other people get out of it?
Yeah, Entrepreneurs Organisation is the most incredible network of entrepreneurs, and it's global. So the amazing thing is, you know, you're networking with people in very different businesses, and they're sharing, you know, all the highs and lows of their business in a raw sense. So you're learning through their experiences, and I think, you know, as an entrepreneur, it's quite difficult, you know, to get guidance, particularly, you know, out there in the broader community. And this is kind of a microcosm of very accomplished entrepreneurs that really, you know, share the, you know, all of the, you know, the hidden tricks that they've learnt in their businesses, and you can sort of, you know, borrow, you know, from their experiences and mould your own business accordingly. I think it's a tremendous resource.
Yeah, because we're not competing with each other, then you can actually rely and tell the secrets to the other people within your small little core group.
Yeah.
So it's almost like getting 10 property investors together and saying, well, let's work out the pros and cons of different strategies and work on it together.
You know, I think one of the key things with Entrepreneurs Organisation is the idea of confidentiality. So when you're surrounded with a, you know, small group of entrepreneurs in your forum, or more broadly, if you go to an event, you know, everyone's sort of, you know, bought into that idea of confidentiality. You can talk openly, you can talk about the things that are going wrong in your business and get some, you know, some great, you know, insights into how other people have got through similar situations. It's fantastic.
So definitely people in business worth having a look at. But getting back to renovations, how big's the industry? Like, how many dollars are people spending on these things?
Well, we've had more than $1 billion worth of work go through our website. And in any month, in the last 30 days, we've had more than $40 million worth of work go through the website. And it's, you know, the typical job can be, you know, around $1,100, you know, a house painting or interior house painting or tiling. But you've got people that are, you know, building second floors or building new houses as well. So, you know, there's no sort of typical job that goes on, but, you know, there's anywhere from, you know, the last 30 days, about 43,000 jobs were posted through the site. So there's a lot of renovation.
And generally, is the cost of renovations increasing? Like, if you look at what a tiling job used to cost kind of a few years ago?
We only just recently released our renovation consumer price index, which follows the traditional CPI. Because the CPI doesn't really do a deep dive into the cost of labour associated with property. It's obviously a basket of goods, you know, to work out whether, you know, there's inflationary pressure in the economy. And we found that, interestingly, you know, as property prices are surging, and you're probably aware of that, you know, in the last quarter, you know, up by, you know, almost 4%, I guess, across the country. Overall, you know, the cost of labour associated with renovating your property is going up as well. So we've found, you know, the hourly rates associated with hiring tradies to do home improvements and renovation, home handiwork, house painting, tiling, have gone up by about 3.7% on average.
I think we've actually got a chart that will pull up some of the numbers on that as well.
Yeah. So yeah. No, it's interesting. So overall, you know, building and home renovations, you know, gone up last quarter by 6.2%, and that's just looking at the cost of labour associated with renovating your house. And then when you do a deep dive and look at the particular trades, carpentry up by 5.5% compared to the quarter before, electrical services 5.2%. Those are sort of trades that are always in high demand. It's very, those are skilled jobs. You need to be licensed, and there's heavy demand for those sorts of services. House painting, flooring, they're all up. And it's, there's more demand in relation to people preparing the house for sale at the moment because prices are surging, and I think there's just more renovation activity, quarter on quarter.
And then we've got a second chart as well that I think some of the things have actually gone down slightly, haven't they?
Well, it's funny, so landscaping and tiling, they're down, gyprock and plaster, it's kind of even, 1.4% down. Landscapers, they're also competing with gardeners, who I guess are skilling up a little bit in that area as well. So, the prices have gone down maybe because there's a bit more competition from, less skilled, tradies that can come and do a similar job. But it's interesting that that's something that we've seen quarter on quarter.
And I guess the classic question is, if you're going to spend, say, $10,000 or $100,000 on renovations, what's the kind of return going to be?
Look, I think, anecdotally, people talk about a 5x return. And I think, there are certain rules or considerations in working out what type of return you're going to get. You need to look at the particular suburb and make sure that you're not overcapitalising. You've got to look at the most expensive property in the suburb and work out how much you're proposing to spend on the renovation, because if you're never going to be able to recoup the investment, it's not a good idea to spend, that amount of money.
Because I guess a lot of it depends on how much money you're spending, because I think, a paint and a carpet is probably the best money you could ever spend, bang for your buck. Whereas if you go and gut the whole thing and spend $100,000, it's hard to increase something $500,000.
And I think a lot of consumers are watching these DIY reality shows, and they've got an idea about the kitchen and the bathroom. And I guess the trends that we're seeing come from some of those shows that what can deliver a wow factor but on a budget. So if you've got a $500,000-$700,000 place, you don't want to spend more than $20,000. If you're preparing the house for sale, because you might not get it back. You've got to look at how to get the best rate of return, I guess.
So certainly one of the keys that we always talk about on the show is actually to go and get things like valuations or get sales agents to actually give you an idea of what your house is worth now, what it's worth afterwards, then find out how much you're going to spend on renovations, and then see if you're actually going to make a profit. Well, after the break, we check out the latest trends in renovations. We'll be back soon.
Celebrate Australia Day, we're having a sale to some of your favourite holiday destinations, like Sydney to the Gold Coast for $45, Perth to Sydney for $129, or Melbourne Tullamarine to Singapore for just $199. There's a one-way, check baggage not included, but may be added for an additional fee. Selected travel dates apply. Sale ends midnight Eastern Daylight Time January 28 unless sold out prior. Sale may be extended, conditions apply. To book, visit jetstar.com.
You get your whole life sorted on that thing, don't you?
Pretty much.
Well, not your whole life. Your finances are sorted into files. Two files. And a box under the bed. I'm thinking you might need some help. Let me show you something.
You can see ANZ Smart Choice Super next to your other ANZ accounts. With Australia's lowest retail super fees, you could have more for your future.
Thanks for the tip. Of course, you can always keep that under the bed.
I didn't think I'd miss you, now I'm feeling like a fool. Ooh.
What's Australia doing on Australia Day? Well, keep your eyes on Sky News all day long and you won't miss a single thing. From the biggest events to the smallest things, conversations with the award winners, and we'll have plenty of the stuff that doesn't normally get enough coverage. Plus, we'll be travelling 5 hours in that-ish direction, and we will bring you a special edition of Paul Murray Live from a very special country town. Come on, mate. My car, my ride. Over. Don't look at me like that. You can drive another highway. Happy Australia Day from all of us at Sky News.
Welcome back to the show. Now, tonight we're talking about renovations, and I'm joined by Jeremy Levitt from serviceseeking.com.au, which has had over $1 billion go through its website on renovations. So I guess the next question, Jeremy, is everyone's always scared of renovations going wrong. They take twice as long and they take twice as much money. Are there particular jobs that always have the biggest kind of blowouts?
Well, I think we're seeing a lot of consumers shy away from, you know, just hiring one company to manage all facets. I think, you know, obviously people are learning a little bit about DIY stuff and they're coordinating, you know, component parts.
At times,
well,
isn't it?
Can be. You know, you just sometimes you need a license as well to coordinate those things. But you know, or often they'll plan a series of renovations, you know, to do the kitchen, to do the bathroom, but not to do it all at once. Where, and those are some of the things that bring you unstuck when you've got a whole lot of people coming together and you've got to work out how all the parts fit together and when electrical and plumbing.
It's a massive timing thing, and as soon as one person has a delay, then it just
precisely, yeah. And you've got people waiting, and you know, it can be interesting. And I think some of the other things that can lead to cost blowouts are, particularly if you're preparing your house for sale, for example, going for very high-end fittings and fixtures. You know, when you're just trying to sort of deliver a wow factor at the open inspection, you don't necessarily need to get all the Italian gadgetry or, you know, the high-end marble, and you can do it at much lower cost and be more frugal. So
with all the renovations that you've seen going through the site, are there any kind of common themes for trying to make savings, like certain things that they could be doing?
Well, I just think, you know, people are going for those big, you know, do the bathroom, do the kitchen, but don't necessarily gut the whole thing, as you were saying before. And, you know, we're hearing some shrewd stories about people, you know, sort of picking up the fittings and fixtures, you know, it's from Seconds World, or, you know, shopping around online to get the best deal. And I think, you know, some of the characteristics of our consumers who compare quotes from tradies also, you know, you see those same characteristics when they're, you know, getting the fittings and fixtures as well. They will, you know, source quotes online and make sure that they're getting the very best deal.
Yeah. Now, we're obviously, as you mentioned before, we're coming into a great property season. The property market's moving up. It's kind of spring. The sun's shining. It's all good. Does that make people want to do more stuff now that...
There's definitely a lot of demand. Like, we've never seen so much renovation activity in the market. It's growing, you know, in the last year, this time last year, around 24,000 jobs. In the last 30 days, about 43,000 jobs. So it's almost doubled. And I think, obviously, you know, there is a bit of a, you know, the surge in property prices, and people are now turning their attention back to that asset, you know, doing some home improvements, and they're feeling happy about it because they can see that the value's increasing. So.
And again, I think we've got a chart that we can pull up that's, talking about some of the areas.
Well, it's interesting. Well, firstly, you know, you know, we're seeing like quarter on quarter a huge, you know, surge in the number of all sorts of, you know, work carried out. So, you know, you're having a look up here, renovations and extensions, you know, compared to last quarter, up, you know, 30%, carpentry work up 14%. But, you know, air conditioning and heating is quite an interesting one, because obviously as you come into the hotter months, people are ducting their house, you know, because they're sweating, and, you know, that's a simple improvement that can add real value, you know, at low cost. You can get a ducted air conditioning unit installed for $10,000, and, you know, that's something that people look for, particularly in hotter
climates.
And
you can charge the tenants, so you can say to the tenants, right, do you want to pay an extra $50 a week or $20 a week?
Precisely, and we are seeing some of that stuff. But it's interesting to see, you know, as you move into the warmer months, you know, spring and summer and so forth, you do see a lot of outdoorsy projects and, you know, air conditioning and landscaping, alfresco areas, they're all sort of very popular at this time of year.
Okay, and I think we've got the second one just coming up there as well.
Yeah, so, I mean, as you can see right at the bottom, you know, home handiwork, and that's a really interesting one, 83% more people sort of hiring home handymen, and I think those are just little, you know, spruce up one little area or fix the cracks and prepare the house for sale, or, you know, people are seeing that property prices are moving and they're like, we're going to do something small, you know,
My wife did it last night. We had a dinner party, so the day before she got a handyman in. She knew I was absolutely useless with my hands. So again, it's when all the jobs get there's so many, it's just easier to get someone in, say, come in for half a day and just come and fix everything.
Yeah, and I think, you know, but also, you know, you've got, like, people are hiring more fences. Concreting's a popular one as well. Redo the driveway. You know, concrete driveway, that's a bit patchy, or, you know, you did it 20 years ago, you want to redo it and make it look really nice when people come into the house. It's, But across the board, I think in every category, looking at this particular quarter, it's booming, like it's going crazy.
And do you find other trends kind of going throughout the year, that people do things at certain times?
Yeah, in winter months it's heating, you know, and underfloor heating is quite a popular thing. And I think obviously like outdoorsy projects are more popular in warmer months, not as popular in colder months. House painting surges in warmer months because, you know, people think that the weather is more dependable. So if you're going to paint the outside of your house, it's better to pick the warmer months, and that's...
So is it worth being contrarian on these? So if you want air conditioning, are you better off buying it in the middle of winter because there's going to be bargains, or are they doing kind of more volume so you get a volume discount if you do it at the same time?
Precisely. I mean, the laws of demand and supply apply in the renovation market as they do everywhere else. So I think, you know, if you've got the foresight to know that, you know, winter, you know, tradies sometimes aren't as busy as they might be in summer, you know, maybe you get a better deal.
And so, is there ever the perfect time to renovate? Well,
it's such an emotional decision. I think, you know, obviously if you are going to sell the property, then renovating to spruce it up, to deliver that wow factor when people come through the house, I think is really important. But aside from that, I think, you know, you've got to work out, do you have the budget for it? Do you have the time? Do you have the inclination? And are you going to get your money back at the end? And I think, you know, obviously around now, when you're seeing such a surge in property prices, it's a fantastic time to renovate because there is a high likelihood that you're going to make a great rate of return on the other end. And when, you know, we've come out of a period of sort of flat prices, and I think, you know, now we're really seeing people sort of hurrying into the market to spruce up their house, you know, because they think they can make some money at the other end.
I mean, we're always talking about making sure you don't overcapitalise, but again, for some homeowners, if they're going to be in there for 20 or 30 years, then certainly make the house as you want it to be.
Precisely. You know, and it's like, are you an investor or an owner-occupier, you know, spend a little bit because it's, you know, that's where you live and where you spend all your time. Investors need to think about, you know, getting a rate of return on the dollars that they put into the apartment.
So certainly some good advice there, and we'll be back soon with a few more tips on how to renovate and what some of the trends are. We'll be back soon.
Every one of our 15,000 products comes with a guarantee. Like this pencil, this tablet, even these sticky notes.
Find a cheaper identical stocked item and we'll beat it by 5%.
Well, that's a good idea.
If you've got the big ideas, Officeworks has the lowest prices.
He's to the mavericks, the rustlers and the hustlers. He's to the looters, freebooters and sharpshooters. Those who dance on the edge of their own graves. Here's to those who forge the frontier of the Wild West. 1 month of classic westerns. Summer on the Range begins Monday, February 3rd. Fox Classics.
I want to be a famous singer.
I want to be a drummer in an all-girls band.
I want to be an actor.
I want to be a State of Origin star.
I want to be a scientist.
I want to be the person that finds a cure for kids' cancer.
I want to be Day, February 28. Dress up as what you want to be and donate to the Kids Cancer Project or buy a bear.
What's Australia doing on Australia Day? Well, keep your eyes on Sky News all day long and you won't miss a single thing. From the biggest events to the smallest things, no matter where they are in the country. We'll have conversations with the award winners and we'll have plenty of the stuff that doesn't normally get enough coverage. Plus, my newly acquired 1983 Commodore SLE, will be travelling 5 hours in that-ish direction and we will bring you a special edition of Paul Murray Live from a very special country town. So all day and well into the night, we've got you covered for a great Australia Day. Right here on Sky News. Come on, mate. My car, my ride. Over. Psst. Don't look at me like that. You can drive off the highway.
Happy Australia Day from all of us at Sky News.
Welcome back to the show. Again, we're joined by Jeremy Levitt from serviceseeking.com.au and we're talking about renovations. So if you've got time over this Christmas holiday, maybe you could think about doing some renovations and see if it can increase your property's value. So Jeremy, obviously from maybe when our parents were around, there was no internet. The internet's massive now. How's that changed the renovation industry?
It's a real game changer. I think, you know, in the olden days, getting quotes for trades and services was a real mission. You'd, you know, speak to a friend, and if they had a good experience with someone, they might recommend them to you. You'd pick up the old yellow book, you'd, you know, ask around, and you'd get one or two quotes. And I think what the internet has done is made it far more accessible to reach a huge number of tradies all at once, but kind of anonymously. So you're not having that deep connection on the phone with someone. You can, you know, use a website like serviceseeking.com.au, post a job, and we'll broadcast that out to all of the tradies that are available to quote on it. And you can pick and choose based on, you know, who's got the best price, who's got the most feedback on their profile, you know, licenses. You know, we review everyone, you know, check their credentials to make sure there are no dodgy tradies on there. And I think, you know, the power is very much now in the consumer's hands. Before, you know, the tradie, you know, if they didn't pick up the phone, they know you're going to call them back. But now, you know, they've got to compete to win your job. And I think the internet has, you know, put the power back in the consumer's hands, and they can choose exactly the right tradie for the job. And, you know, it's very different from how it used to be before.
But it's amazing how big it is, because I remember coming across your business, and then for one minute I didn't know it, and then I suddenly, every bus I was passing had Service Seeking all over it, and then finding out you've done $1 billion through the website. It's massive. And I think we've got a chart coming up saying, with some of your key numbers on there, about how big it really is.
Yeah, no, it's interesting. The you know, we started off, you know, with a couple of jobs a month, and, you know, in the last, you know, 30 days, you know, to crack that 40,000 jobs in a month. And it's, you know, we've had over 900,000 customers all around Australia that have, you know, used our website to organise trades and services, from house painters to electricians and everything in between. 150,000 quotes get submitted by tradies every month. You know, it's worth, you know, $40 million a month. It's like a huge...
It's massive, and we'll try and get that chart up any second. But it's some serious numbers there, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. So we've had more than 3 million quotes submitted through the website. So the, you know, the data that we accumulate, you know, we know how much it costs to get things done. You know, we can see what people are charging. You know, more than $1 billion worth of, you know, transactions have gone through the site. You know, 900,000 customers, you know, are now going online to organise trades and services. Before, they were asking around, they were struggling. You know, now they just need to post a job, and it gets broadcast out to people that can do it. And the fantastic thing about it is only people that are available to do the work can contact you, and they've got to give a price. So it's none of this, like,
and
being
so
uncertain.
For the classic things that, if people have never renovated before, you've got over most of the issues. So they've got to be licensed, they've got to be available, they've got to give you a price. So there's suddenly no messing around all the time.
No messing around. And the great thing about it is that all the reviews, so we've had more than 40,000 reviews left for tradies on our site. You know, so the old days of asking mum or a friend, you know, about a tradie to get that word of mouth thing, you can read 100 reviews about, you know, a particular tradesman, and they're verified because they're about other jobs that have been posted through the site.
You know, because it's so easy now, just like we've got Facebook and Twitter and everything else, is if someone does the wrong thing, it's very easy to post online.
We've also got a two strikes and you're out policy. So unlike the Yellow Pages and Google, who will take anyone, if we get two complaints about a tradesman, they're gone and we kick them off the site. So the chances of getting somebody dodgy are extremely low.
And there are other particular areas that you're kind of finding trends, like certain people doing things in certain places?
Well, I think, you know, it's funny, the number of jobs that get posted on our site kind of marry up with the population density, you know, around the various capital cities. So we see, obviously, Sydney has got the most sort of activity from a jobs perspective, followed by Melbourne, Brisbane. Perth is an interesting case as well, because, you know, the mining and resources boom over there, quite a lot of jobs get posted, and the tradies typically charge a lot more than they do elsewhere in Australia, up to 20% more, in fact. And, you know, then you've got sort of Adelaide, which is, you know, one of the cheapest places to renovate your house because the cost of living is so low there compared to the rest of Australia. So, you know, it's interesting. But, you know, Eastern Seaboard is obviously where the majority of the activity is.
Now, obviously, you've got a vested interest in this this question, but what would you say are some of the benefits of trying to find some of these tradies online versus doing the more traditional things?
Well, I think when you use a website like serviceseeking.com.au, the tradies that are quoting know they're in a competitive process, so they're not trying to gouge you. You know, you just haven't randomly called them out of the blue when they've already got a job on. They need work, and they know that there are other people chasing the work as well, so you're going to get a very sharp price. And our own research says that consumers typically save 15% on quotes that they get through service seeking compared to other channels. And it's basically because you're getting 5 to 12 quotes and the tradies know that they've got to be competitive. So.
And I guess at the same time then, if they did the wrong thing by someone before, they're going to disappear off and they don't know anything else. Whereas if they know they're getting a large part of their business through service seeking, well, then they don't want to cut off their nose.
We've seen some tradesmen that have grown their business 100-fold through our site. You know, they've got, you know, a PA chasing up all the quotes and coordinating their diaries. And the idea of a tradie, you know, with a paper diary is gone now. They're sophisticated. They know how to, you know, to impress a client, to turn up on time. You know, they know how to quote well. And the idea of the whole gouging experience that I think a lot of people that use the Yellow Pages and Google to find tradies experience before is gone now, because, you know, you can get tradies involved in a competitive process online and get the very best price for the job.
Wonderful. Well, thanks for joining us this evening.
Thank you very
much,
Chris.
Good to hear about a business, because it certainly is just trying to make life easier for everyone else that's out there. Good to see you.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for joining us on the show this evening. I hope you've enjoyed the special show on renovations. And also, for you, if you're out in business, then certainly check out the Entrepreneurs Organisation. They may be able to help you grow your business at the same time as well. I look forward to seeing you again next week. Until then, I'm Chris Gray. Good night.
The information featured in this program is general in nature and therefore should not be relied upon. Guests appearing on the program may have commercial arrangements with some of the companies mentioned. Before making any investment, insurance or financial planning decisions, you should consult a licensed professional who can advise whether your decision is appropriate for you.